Hi, my name is Chuck. I'm with Midwest Energy and Communications. And today I would like to tell you how to access your router's interface in order to change things, such as your wireless name and password. One thing that's very important to begin is that you have a laptop or a computer in the same room as the router. And we actually have to be connected to the router with an Ethernet cable into one of the yellow Ethernet ports on the back of the device. This is going to be the best way to connect to the router and ensure you have a good connection and a stable connection while you change settings. Then, the other piece of information on the router that you can use is the username and password printed on the sticker that was placed there by the installer. That is the security way to access the device's settings. Once you're at your computer, with an Ethernet cable connected to the router, you should see a symbol very similar to this. You're going to want to open a browser such as Internet Explorer or Google Chrome. In the browser, we have a address bar at the top, and we also have a search bar. It's very important that what we're going to type in goes in the address bar and not the search bar. In the address bar, you should type in the IP address located on the sticker of your ONT, which in this case is 192.168.1.1. When you type in this address, it takes you to the actual router, not the internet. The username is admin, all lowercase, as shown on the bottom of the sticker. And the password is the random letters and numbers after. In my case, it is DD26D102. Yours will be different. Once we log into the router, this is how we access the settings. This is how we change the Wi-Fi name and password. We have many categories, most of which you won't have to use, but in the middle, we have one called wireless. In the wireless, we can see over here on the left-hand side, we have the 2.4 network and the 5 network. On the radio setup, we should see radio on if you're using our Wi-Fi. Then we want to go to SSID setup. SSID is a very fancy way to say your Wi-Fi name. Here in our front lobby, we have it named MEC IoT 2.4G. Down here in this box, you can select it, delete it, and rename it whatever you'd like it to be. In this case, I'm going to leave it, but you'll hit apply when you're ready. Under security, we have the default security key, which is located on the sticker, but most homes have a custom security key. Make sure that this radio button is checked and type in exactly what you'd like your wireless security key to be. It is very important that you use exactly capital, lowercase, numbers, and punctuation to your desired effect, because it has to match exactly when you enter it in on a device. Once you apply, you simply repeat the process for the 5 gigahertz network, 5G network, SSID setup. When you name the 5G, make sure it's different from the 2.4, even if you just change the 5G on the end. In security, the custom security key can match exactly. Once you have applied all these settings, you can simply close your browser. You'll see that all of your devices in your home are no longer connected to Wi-Fi because you've changed the service. And then you'll simply have to use the settings on those devices and reconnect just like you would if you went to the public library or your friend's house.